At the time of the first Exodus, 30 days after the children of Israel left Egypt, they pitched camp at the wilderness of Sin. It was here that they murmured against the Most High to Moses and Aaron for food. Even after seeing the Red Sea part with their own eyes, they were worried that Yahweh would not or could not provide food for them, and they complained against him. Yahweh provided the manna and quails for them at this time. At some point in the year that followed, Yahweh tested them by removing the quails. In Numbers chapter 11, we are told that in the second year, the manna was not good enough for them, and they lusted for flesh, and they complained against the Most High for this. At that time, he rained down quail upon them for 30 days, and he showed them his hot indignation by sending a plague upon them that killed those of them who lusted. His doing so for 30 days is not a coincidence. Concerning the time of the end, his word says in Zechariah 11:8, I will also cut off three shepherds in 1 month. I loathe their lives, and their lives will be reaped. And in Hosea 5:7, they, speaking of Israel and specifically separating out Judah and Ephraim in the preceding verses, have transgressed against Yahweh, and they have brought forth children that are strangers to me. Now in a month I will devour them amongst their portion. Most of the coming time of calamity will be in the final 7 days, the great fearful day of his wrath. However, these verses also place great significance in the final 30 days. Through the testimony of Yahweh's word and through his end-time messenger of his covenant, he has restored his 30-day months. Therefore, he has restored the correct timing of his Sabbaths and the rest of his appointed times. His word says in Isaiah 58, and from you I will build the vanished places that were made desolate by the false shepherds, and I will rise up the foundation of many generations, and he, referring to the one who would be sent to restore all things, will be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of paths to dwell in. You need to join in with me in becoming a repairer of the breach, a restorer of paths to dwell in. Verse 13, if you will return your feet to my Sabbath, returning to it means that it had to be restored in order to return to it, and do my desire on my set apart day, and call the Sabbath a delight, the sanctified of Yahweh, and glorify it, and glorify my path, referring to glorifying his Torah, and attain my desire by speaking my words, then you will delight upon Yahweh, and you will ride upon the high places of the earth, and I will feed you with the heritage of Jacob your father, because the mouth of Yahweh has spoken it. After these 30 days, they traveled to Hazeroth. It was at Hazeroth that Aaron and Miriam rose up against Yahweh's chosen servant Moses and spoke against him for marrying the Ethiopian woman. Yahweh's wrath was kindled against them for doing so. How do you think he feels about those of you who have spoken against his end-time messenger of his covenant? After Yahweh gave the children of Israel manna and the quails in the wilderness of Sin, they encamped at Dophkah and then Elush, and then they arrived at Rephidim at Horeb, and there was no water there. Instead of beseeching Yahweh to provide for them, they murmured against him to Moses. They were even considering stoning Moses at this time. Yahweh showed himself strong to them by sending forth the water from the rock. It was at this time that Yahweh rose up Amalek to war against Israel. Moses went up on a hill with Elohim's rod in his hand, and he brought Aaron and Hur with him. And in Exodus 17:11 we read, and it was that when Moses held up his hands, Israel prevailed, and that when he let down his hands, Amalek prevailed. Yahweh continued to show himself strong to them through his anointed servant Moses, and he will do so for you in the coming days if you will stand with his anointed servant at this time. Moses' arms got tired, so Aaron and Hur gave him a stone to sit upon, and they stood on each side of him and helped him hold up his hands, and Israel prevailed. O Israel, how much different it is for Israel's descendants today. There are no others besides my family standing with Yahweh's servant at this time. At least our ancestors fled the captivity back then. At least they went with Moses. Yes, they murmured against the Most High, but they stayed fled through the 40 years in the desert. Today, the scattered descendants of Israel refuse to even flee from the captivity for the second Exodus. You are in love with Babylon. You are in love with the lies that Yahweh gave you over to believe into. You are perfectly content to sit on your soft cushions instead of desiring the Most High's righteousness. You are perfectly content to hide behind your false salvation doctrines instead of fearing going against that which His word tells you to do. In Ezekiel 13, the prophets or the false shepherds of Israel are like jackals in the places of desolation. They have not risen up the breaches, neither have they closed up the walls so that the house of Israel will be able to stand in the battle in the day of Yahweh. The walls that you hide behind are dubbed with untempered mortar, and they will soon come crashing down upon you if you do not get from behind them. The witness that our Elohim has sent me to you with has testified against you. Not only has it testified to your rebellion to that which his word tells you to do, it has testified against you because you refuse to return to him through that which he has restored. You murmur against his righteousness in your uncircumcised hearts. Not only do you refuse to come out from Babylon, you refuse to even acknowledge that you are in her. Back then, Aaron and Hur held up Moses' hands. Like I said, currently there are none standing with Yahweh's anointed at his camp besides his family. How do you think that he feels and he looks upon you for your refusal to return to him through that which he has restored? How do you think he feels about you refusing to stand with his second anointed son? How do you think that he feels about you trampling his only begotten son's shed blood under your feet, using it for a license to transgress against him? Well, you're about to find out. You're going to become acquainted with his hot indignation firsthand. You're going to find out that you are not standing with that which would cause you to stand in the battle of the great and the fearful day of Yahweh's wrath. You're going to find out that your walls are dubbed with untempered mortar. The only way that you're going to be able to stand in the coming battle is if you turn from your rebellion to Yahweh and return to him through that which he has restored. You need to stand with his anointed servant and hold up my hands by lifting up the offering in righteousness that he has bid for you to offer up to him at this time. Like I said, you need to join in with me in becoming a repairer of the breach, a restorer of paths to dwell in. Thus saith Yahweh Elohim's word.